These are the FDA medications for adults: atomoxetine, dimethylphenidate, dexmethylphenidate, a triple bead, a mixed bead, which is a double bead, and orris methylphenidate. And again, I'm not going to go through the details of the slide. These are things you can print out if you find them useful. I do want to make one highlight on this, though. Let's look at atomoxetine, because I mentioned earlier this nurse practitioner was writing doses beyond the FDA max. And again, if you do that, it's off-label. I'm not standing here cavalierly prescribe all kinds of dosing to your patient, but it's done thoughtfully. But let me point to some research information that substantiates my position on this. If you look at atomoxetine, the max dose in the PI is 100 milligrams, and yet the clinical trial went up to 120 milligrams. So these max doses are not necessarily a function of safety. It's just the registration trials that were submitted to the FDA and how they make a decision. If you look at dexmethylphenidate, max dose is 20 milligrams. Clinical trials in adults went to 40 milligrams. Triple beaded, max dose 50 milligrams. Clinical trial went to 75. 75 was never submitted because of some AE difficulties, and you can imagine insomnia. Mixed amphetamine salts, if you look in the package insert, there is no max dose for mixed amphetamine salt XR. And every time I say that, I have to go back to the PR and say, did I say that right? It's true. So why is 60 milligrams used? Because that was the dosing that we used in the clinical trials. I was a PI on several of these as well. And orris methylphenidate, here's something really interesting. The max dose is 72 milligrams. When we did the dose optimization trials, we ran up to 108 milligrams. 33% of the adults in that trial were over 72 milligrams. Think about that for a moment. One third of the patients in a dose optimization trial were higher than the FDA max dose. If you don't know this, one third of your patients is going to be underdosed.